Now let's take a look at the tools in the HTML editor here in Silverstripe. I'm only going to cover the first two rows because the third row is a series of buttons for creating and editing tables, and that's covered in a separate video in this tutorial series. So look for that video in our Silverstripe CMS training playlist and then you'll learn all about those buttons. But for now we'll just talk about these first two rows. In order to use these tools, we need to have some content here in our content area, so I'll get some from a sample document I have here. So I'll just take my content and copy that. Go back to my browser here, put my cursor in here. Now, there are a couple of different ways to paste from Word, and make sure that no formatting comes in from Word that would override our styles like fonts and font sizes and colors and things like that. We don't want any of that kind of formatting to come over from Word because it can make the content inconsistent with the rest of the website by the fact that those styles override the styles that are in the style sheet that's been written and designed for the website that you're working on. So in order to prevent Word from bringing that over, you can just click the Paste from Word button and paste your content right in that little box and hit Insert. And you'll see that the extra formatting was stripped out, but it did retain the paragraph breaks. Also, you'll see that pretty much everything is being marked as incorrectly spelled, but that's just because it's lorem ipsum and not English. So we'll take this first line and make it into a heading. Now this field up here, page name, is the main heading of the page in my website that I'm working on. So I'll show you what that looks like on the front end. We'll just save this draft and take a look at it in the preview mode. So this heading right here is my heading level 1 or H1, and whatever I type in the page name field is what's inserted here. So that means that the headings that are in the content below are subheads of this main header. So when you're defining headers in your content in HTML, you need to keep in mind that it's like a outline. There's a hierarchy to it, and you should only select heading levels based on their meaning and not what they look like. Let the style sheet decide what they look like, but format the content according to what the headings mean. So since these are both subheads of the main name of the page, then I'm going to set them as heading level 2. Just like this. You can actually change the heading level by just clicking the cursor into the middle of the text. You don't actually have to select the whole line in order to apply this kind of formatting, because this kind of formatting only applies to entire paragraphs. Things like bold and italic will be able to apply to words within paragraphs. So we'll make that bold and maybe make these italic, just like that. And then these four buttons are about text alignment, and I would suggest only using those if you absolutely have to, because it's better to allow the alignments that are set up in the style sheet for the site's web design, its graphic design. It's better to allow that style sheet to define the alignment of the content rather than overriding it by choosing another alignment. Sometimes your web developer will have provided you some extra styles in this drop-down. I have a couple in here that are used for making embedded videos responsive, but there may be other styles in there that have been provided by your web developer in order to do additional styling within the content here, like maybe a color or something like that. If you have a style applied to something and you don't want it anymore, and there isn't any, like, none item in this drop-down, to get it removed, you would just hit this little eraser button and it would remove the formatting. Now we can maybe make some of this content into a bullet list, so I'll make some items here, separate them out from the rest of the content, just like this. And I'll make those three lines into a bullet list. And all I have to do is just select them and click the bullet list. Or I can make it into a numbered list like that. These buttons are for increasing or decreasing the level of indent for the lists. And then we'll take and separate another piece of this content here. And we'll make this into a block quote. So this is the block quote button, and it just sets a section of text off from the rest by indenting it on both sides. And you can use it for callouts, quotes, and things like that. And then we have the horizontal rule, which will put a rule between elements on the page and separate them if you need it. And then this button allows you to insert special characters. So let's say we wanted to set this phrase off from that phrase with an M dash. We could remove that period and space and click this and select our M dash character, and it just inserts it right there like that. This is the undo button, and this is the redo button if you've clicked the undo button and you realize you want to go back to the way it was. Here are your cut and copy and paste buttons. You can also use your key commands for your browser if you know them, or you can use the edit menu. Same thing, but it might be simpler for some of you to just click these buttons for those purposes. This will select all the text in the editing area. And this one will insert an image, so we'll go ahead and look at inserting an image. I'll put it above all the content here. If you click Insert Image or Insert Media, then it'll give you an interface. You could drag a JPEG here, or you could browse for the file here, or if you already have some images uploaded into your CMS, you can go to the From the CMS tab and find the image that you want to place. Now, this From the Web tab, you can only link to images that are hosted somewhere else, and I wouldn't suggest using this because especially if the image is hosted in somebody else's website, if they ever take that image down, then suddenly your page has a broken image on it, and that's not good. So I recommend you don't ever use the From the Web tab, but only from the CMS or from your computer, depending upon what you're doing. So I'll just select this image and have a look at its settings. I'll just make it 300 pixels wide and insert it. And I do have a separate tutorial about inserting images that'll go into more depth about that, but here's my image. And then we have the anchor button. And this is for if you want to set an anchor on a page and then link directly to that section of the page, then all you have to do is put the anchor where you want it to appear. Now, I always like to put them at the end of the line, because if I put it at the beginning, it'll put an invisible space here. Well, it'll be a space that's visible, but it'll be an invisible anchor tag, but it will look like a space and it will push this over. So if I don't want that space to push the text over, I just put it at the other end of the line. So we'll go ahead and click that button, and it brings up a little pop-up where we can name the anchor. And the rules about naming anchors are they must begin with a letter and not a number, and they cannot have any spaces in them, and they have to be unique on the page. So we'll just call this one first anchor. So there's my little anchor. I can see it here in this CMS editor, but on the front end, it'll be invisible. And so I'll put another one here. And there's my other little anchor. So I'll just save this. Now, if I wanted to link to those anchors, then I can put a link up here. And I'm just going to make that to be a paragraph instead of a heading. And then I can choose Insert Link. And if I choose Anchor on this page, then I see the anchors that I've set in this dropdown. And so I'll just insert that link there. So if I'm on this page and I click this link, it's going to jump me down to this anchor. And if I want to remove a link from a set of words, then I can just have that be selected and click this remove link button or unlink button. This button gives us the HTML markup of this particular page content, and this is useful if you need to get in there and change something, and it's easier sometimes to just do it in the code than it is to try to edit the content with the tools. So there may be instances where you need to pop this up, like if you wanted to embed a Google map or a YouTube video onto a page, you would have to paste the code that you get from Google into this HTML pop-up. We'll just close that. And this one allows you to put your HTML editor in a full screen mode so that you can see better what you're doing. So I'm going to save and publish my page and have a look at it in the preview. All right, so there's my image and my italics and bold, bullet list. Here's my block quote. It's got slightly larger text and a little border on the side. And there's my horizontal rule. And here's my link to jump to the part of the page where that anchor is sitting.